Good morning. We've already derived many simple harmonic motion equations. Today we are going to derive the equation for velocity as a function of position for a horizontal mass spring system.
Velocity as a function of position? What is that?
Sure, we usually look at variables as a function of time, but velocity as a function of position is just going to be an equation for velocity in terms of position instead of time.
Okay.
Flippin' physics!
Alright. So we know the total mechanical energy of a horizontal mass spring system equals the sum of the kinetic and elastic potential energies at any point. And we already determined that the total mechanical energy of a mass spring system equals 1/2 spring constant times amplitude squared. Bobby, please solve this equation for velocity.
Well, I think we should start by saying,
everybody brought 1/2 to the party.
Everybody brought mass.
Considering we really just multiply through by 2, that does seem a bit excessive. However, sure. Everybody brought 1/2 to the party. Bobby?
Subtract spring constant times displacement from equilibrium squared from both sides of the equation. On the right side, we can factor out the spring constant and divide both sides by mass to solve for velocity squared. Then we can take the square root of the whole equation to get velocity equals the square root of the quantity spring constant over mass all times the quantity amplitude squared minus distance from equilibrium position squared.
And in a mass spring system, angular frequency equals the square root of spring constant over mass.
Nice.
Which means the velocity of a mass spring system as a function of position equals angular frequency times the square root of the quantity amplitude squared minus distance from equilibrium position squared.
I think we need to be careful to add plus or minus to the velocity equation.
Why?
Because otherwise we might not remember that the velocity of the mass spring system is negative when it is moving to the left, and any time you take the square root, the answer could be positive or negative.
Sure.
Wonderful. Thank you all. Now, let's take a look at what that graph looks like. Here you can see the velocity of the horizontal mass spring system as a function of position. Bo, please tell me what you see.
Sure. When the position of the mass is at the amplitude, or the maximum displacement from equilibrium position, either to the left or to the right, the velocity equals zero. That makes sense because the mechanical energy of this mass spring system is entirely elastic potential energy at that point, so there is zero kinetic energy. And the velocity of the mass is changing directions, and therefore the velocity has to equal zero. When the mass is passing through equilibrium, the magnitude of the velocity is at a maximum value. Again, that makes sense because the displacement from equilibrium is zero. Therefore, there is zero elastic potential energy, which means all the mechanical energy is kinetic energy. And the shape of the velocity as a function of position graph is an ellipse. Is it really an ellipse? I mean, clearly you have graphed it as an ellipse, but how is that an equation for an ellipse?
That is a fair question, Bo. The general equation for an ellipse centered at the origin is y squared over a squared plus x squared over b squared equals 1, where a and b are constants. If we square our velocity as a function of position equation, we could divide both sides by angular frequency squared and add x position squared to both sides, and we get velocity squared over angular frequency squared plus x position squared equals amplitude squared. This is an equation for an ellipse, where a equals the angular frequency, b equals 1, and rather than 1 on the right-hand side, we have amplitude squared. However, amplitude squared is still just a number on the right-hand side. So yeah, this equation describes an ellipse. Actually, another interesting way to look at this equation is to rearrange the equation a little bit more. Under the radical, we can multiply by amplitude squared over amplitude squared because that equals 1, and you can multiply any number by 1. And the number does not change. we can multiply amplitude squared through in the denominator, and the square root of amplitude squared is just amplitude, and amplitude squared over amplitude squared, again, equals 1. Can anyone tell me why I had us rearrange the equation this way?
Okay. Remember a few lessons ago, we derived that the maximum velocity in simple harmonic motion equals amplitude times angular frequency. That means we can substitute maximum velocity in for amplitude times angular frequency, and we get that the velocity as a function of position for a mass spring system equals plus or minus the maximum velocity times the square root of 1 minus the quantity of displacement from equilibrium position squared over amplitude squared.
Yeah, and you can see this equation shows the velocity of the mass is at its maximum magnitude when the mass spring system is at the equilibrium position, because the displacement from equilibrium position equals 0, and according to this equation, the velocity at x position equals 0 equals plus or minus the maximum velocity.
And it shows the velocity equals 0 when the mass spring system is at its amplitude or maximum displacement from equilibrium, because the equation works out to equal 0 when the displacement from equilibrium position equals amplitude.
Cool.
Yeah.
Is it me, or is the highlighted part of the velocity as a function of position ellipse moving at a constant angular velocity?
What?
Yeah, it does look like that. Why would the position of the velocity as a function of position curve, which matches the simple harmonic motion of the mass spring system, move with a constant angular velocity?
Yeah.
That is a great question. To understand this, we have to go all the way back to remembering that simple harmonic motion is the one-dimensional projection of an object moving at a constant angular velocity. In other words, when we have an object on a record player moving at a constant angular velocity, and we isolate just the x position motion of that object revolving at a constant angular velocity, and we plot the x position of that object revolving at a constant angular velocity as a function of time, we get a cosine curve. Therefore, when we plot velocity as a function of position and isolate the portion of that curve which corresponds to the motion of a mass spring system moving in simple harmonic motion, that isolated portion of the ellipse changes its angle with respect to the origin at a constant rate, which means it moves with a constant angular velocity, just like the record player is moving at a constant angular velocity.
Yay!
Whoa.
Yeah.
I forgot how much circular motion and simple harmonic motion are related. Thanks for reminding us of that, Mr. Pete.
You are welcome, Billy. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.